Google Cloud virtual machines are going to change the way you develop applications. Forget limitations. Compute Engine lets you build and customize virtual machines running a multitude of operating systems, from Linux favorites like Debian and Ubuntu to the robust Windows server. This demo will break down how to spin up a virtual machine using the Google Cloud console and the gcloud command line in Cloud Shell, and you'll also learn to connect an NGINX web server to your VM. So let's get started. To kick things off, we need to activate Cloud Shell. Cloud Shell is a virtual machine that is loaded with development tools, but specifically, Cloud Shell enables command line access to your Google Cloud resources. Activating Cloud Shell is incredibly easy. We'll simply click the Activate Cloud Shell button. We'll click Continue, and we're up and running and can now drop in some commands. Once we're connected, we're already authenticated, and the project is set to our project ID. Now, before we go any further, it's important to understand regions and zones. A region is a specific geographical location where you can run your resources. Each region has one or more zones. For example, the US Central 1 region indicates a region in the central United States that has zones US Central 1A, US Central 1B, US Central 1C, and US Central 1F. Virtual machine instances and persistent disks live in a zone. And to attach a persistent disk to a virtual machine instance, both resources must be in the same zone. Similarly, if you want to assign a static IP address to an instance, the instance must be in the same region as the static IP. So let's run a command to set the project region, and then we'll set a variable for that region, and then we'll set a variable for the zone as well. Okay, cool. We're doing good so far. Time to create a new instance. So in the Google Cloud console, we're going to go to the main navigation menu and select Compute Engine and then VM Instances. And now we're going to click the big button that says Create Instance. Okay, now we can give our instance a name and set the region and zone we want it to run in. And there are a few different types of machines we can choose from depending on our needs. We actually have a video on these different types, and we included a link to that video in the description. We're gonna go with general purpose for now and select a series. Now, we're gonna skip past a few sections until we get to boot disk, and this is the image we want our VM to run on. Several images are available, including Debian, Ubuntu, CoreOS, and premium images such as Red Hat Enterprise Linux and Windows Server. Next, let's check out the firewall settings. We want to allow HTTPS traffic, which gives access to a web server that we'll install later. And now we're ready to click Create. It'll take a minute or so to spin up the instance. Now, we can connect to the VM by clicking the SSH button, or we can connect to the instance via gcloud and the CLI. Let's use gcloud in this case and add the gcloud compute SSH command, followed by the name of the VM instance we just created, gcelab. We'll type Y to continue, and we'll press Enter through the passphrase section to leave the passphrase empty. All right, and we're done. No, we're not done. Our VM is up and running, but next we need to install an NGINX web server. This is one of the most popular web servers in the world, and it can interact with VMs in several powerful ways. For example, it can receive client requests and forward them to the VM to help with load balancing, caching static content, and enhancing security. So the first step is to update the OS, which we can do using this command. Success. Next, let's install NGINX. And we should confirm that NGINX is running, which it is, looking good. Okay, we're pretty much up and running. To confirm, let's see if this actually generates a web page. Let's check out the external IP link listed here. It'll pop open a new tab, and it should open the default web page. There we go. Just like that, we're all set. Next, we're going to create a new VM using gcloud. And to create the new VM, we need to disconnect from SSH. And we can do that by simply typing exit. So instead of using the cloud console to create a VM instance, we can use gcloud commands in Cloud Shell. Now that we've already done the setup work, this is pretty straightforward. We'll enter the gcloud compute instances create command, which will do exactly what it says it will do, and we should see that the VM instance has been instantiated. Boom, instantiated indeed. If everything worked correctly, it will display a synopsis of the new instance. That's a wrap on creating VMs with Compute Engine. Hit that subscribe button for more Google Cloud content, and if you're interested in learning more, we've included links in the description to full courses on Google Cloud Skills Boost and additional resources. We'll see you next time.